Hello, ATs, recent students and teachers. Thank you, sit down. ATs and recent students, I believe you have learned something on product rules and quotient rules in your previous lesson with Ms. Irima. I would like you to reflect back to the steps and methods you have learned. And on the screen, I will show you some exercise for you to do, and you're going to apply the steps and methods on applying the product rule and the quotient rule. ATs and receiving students, the exercise on the screen reads, simplify the following using the product rule. Now, you were taught how to use the product rule by using two methods. First, you were to look at the base and the power itself. The first method is, if you're thinking of adding the powers, you're going to do that. And the second one is the expansion method. So I would like you to try out the two methods in product rule. So the first activity is on the screen now. You can do that in pairs. You can start now. It shouldn't take you long because you should by now know how to find the product rule or use the product rule to calculate the expression there, the index expression. Put your hands up if you are finished. Let's look at the answer for the first one. As long as you have applied one method to find the answer. Okay, let's have somebody on that far side. The group there. What is your answer? Receiving students, you can give your answer as well.
B to the power of 12.
B to the power of 12, very good. Now, the easy method that we all know is when we are adding the powers, okay? The base is the one which is represented by the letter B, and the powers are the small numbers on the top. So what we are going to do is, we are going to add the powers. The product rule says we'll add the powers, which is 7 plus 5 is equals to b to the power of 12. Very good. Now, the other method also which you can use in the product rule is called the expansion method. In the expansion method, what you are going to do is, you're going to outline the base according to the number or the power which is appearing. So for example, B to the power of 7, you will have how many B's?
7
B's, which are going to multiply with B to the power of 5. How many B's there?
5.
So 7 B's times 5 B's. And you are going to get how many?
12
B's. Okay? That's expansion method. You can also use that method to find the index expression. Now, let's try out the other one on applying the quotient rule. I would like you to also apply the two methods, the expansion method and also the one that you all know by adding the powers or subtracting the powers. Who would like to give us the answer for the next one? Okay, Rachel, what do you think the answer for that exercise?
B to the power of 2.
Okay, B to the power of 2. ATS and receiving students, do you think she's correct?
Yes.
Very good. Now, when you apply the method on subtracting the powers, you will have, as it is on the screen, the powers subtracting each other, and you will be left with B to the power of 2. When you apply the expansion method, it will be the same as on the screen, which is you outline the bases. There are how many bases which are known as the dividend? Huh? 7 B's and the divisor?
5
B's. So when you cancel them out, you will have how many B's left on the top? The numerator, 2 B's, and the denominator, how many B's? Is there any B's left? No, there won't be any B's, but number 1 will represent that there's no more B's left. And then you will have B to the power of 2 over 1, which is any number or letter which is over 1 is always known as the number itself. So it will be equals to B to the power of 2. ATS and receiving students, by now you should know how to apply the two methods in the two rules of productive rule and the quotient rule. Now, with the two exercises, I would like you to do further more exercises on the screen. And this is how we are going to do the exercises. In pairs, you think of which rule are you going to apply to solve the two exercises. Our exercise is based on simplifying the following using the quotient rule. We are going to use the quotient rule to find the answers for exercise A and B. Now, when we are trying to find the answer for A and B, I would like you to apply the two methods that you are aware of. You're dealing with the powers and also the expansion method. You outline the basis and you apply the operation needed. So I would like you to do that, and then we'll go through the answers together. You're only given 5 minutes to go through the two exercises. If you are finished with exercise A, you can raise your hand. Atheist and receiving students, if you are finished, you can go up to the board and write your answers down. Atheist, one of our friends has finished, so let's see her work on the first exercise. To the receiving students, you can also do the same by going up to the front and writing the answer for the first exercise on the board. Okay. You are going to apply the two methods, first the powers and secondly the expansion. Class, I will write the answers that she wrote on her book and she will explain the answers. Okay. Okay, that's the first method she used. The second one, okay, that's what she had written down for a working out, so we'll see how she explains her answers.
The first method I used is the quotient rule, and how I got my answer is I got a B, the base, and the powers, 5 and 7. And then our rule says in quotient rule is we have to subtract. So small number cannot subtract by the big number, so I put -2. My answer is B to the power of -2. And my second method is the expansion method. How I got my B's is I got a power of 5, so I put 5 times B's here, and same as the B is down here. And then I got B times B over 1 equals, I subtracted five subtracted by 7, I got B to the power of 2. And my final answer is B to the power of 2.
Okay, thank you. Let's give it 2 big claps. Receiving students, I hope you have got something like that which our friend has given. If you have got a different answer, you can explain to your teacher. It is, let's look at our friends working out on the board. Who disagrees with the working outs, the 2 working outs? Let's look at the first one. The first method, it is, and receiving students, do you all agree with the first answer?
Yes.
First method, very good. Okay, she is correct. And what about the second one? Is there anything wrong? Yes or no? I can hear somebody saying yes. Who's got a different answer or working out to our friends working out here? Well, the problem is the first method that she used, she got B to the power of -2. And the second method, the expansion method, when she used that, the answer was B to the power of +2. Where's the problem? If you are saying that the first one is B to the power of -2, and the second method should show B to the power of -2. So there's something wrong there. Who can explain where she went wrong? Okay, our friend there. Diana, please explain clearly to our friends. Receiving students, you can also check the working out.
The first rule gave the product was B to the power of -2, so this one is positive, so that's wrong. If a problem is given like this, we have to write the answer in fraction. 5 b to the power of 5 on b to the power of 7, you have to write 1 and then get the answer from this one. You have to subtract these two numbers, and then the answer 2 you have to write below, and then this one is only, when you cancel this one, all of the denominator, all of them will be canceled, so you have to write 1 on 2 because the numerator, the 2 will remain, so b to the power of f.
Okay.
And then you remove this one, and then you write b to the power of negative 2.
Okay, thank you. ATs, recent students, who's got a different answer or explanation? Now, let's look at the screen, the working out that I have regarding this using the second method. Okay, the first one, she was correct by doing that. B, the subtracting the two powers and the answer was b to the power of negative 2. Now, when we are doing the expansion method, this is how we are going to do it. That negative 2, b to the power of negative 2, is known as the negative indices. Okay? Let's look at the expansion method. Okay? The expansion method is when b to the power of 5 over b to the power of 7, like what our friend has written. The numerators, how many b's on the numerator? 5. And the denominator?
7.
The next thing in division, what you are going to do is you're going to cancel. Is that clear? You're going to cancel out the numbers or the letters which can be canceled out. Like for example, here the common letter is B, so we cancel out the total number of B's appearing in the numerator and also the denominator. So when we cancel them out, the 5 B's on the numerator cancel out and the 5 B's on the denominator also cancels out. And you are left with how many B's? 2 B's on the numerator or the denominator?
Denominator.
Very good. So, as I've said, when the numerator, if there's no letter or number, the numerator space is going to be represented by number 1, and you will have 2 B's at the bottom. After that, when you times B, it will give you B to the power of 2. Simply means 2 B's. Now, let's look at the exercise B. When we apply the quotient rule, what do you think the answer will be? B to the power of? Okay, let's look at the screen. When we subtract the two powers, 5 minus 5, what will be your answer? 0 or 1? 5 minus 5, what is the answer? Okay, class. When the two powers subtract each other, 5 minus 5, what do you think the answer would be? 5 minus 5 is equals to?
0.
Very good. So, B is B to the power of 0. When we have a index with a 0 or the power 0, that index form is known as 0 indices. Okay? Any number or letter which is power of zero is always equals to?
1.
Very good. Now, 87 receiving students, to clearly see why we got 1, why b to the power of 0 is always equals to 1, we can use the expansion method to find out if b to the power of 0 is equals to 1. Is that clear? The expansion method, again, we spread all the bases out. The numerator, all the, how many b's there? There are 5 b's, and the denominator, how many b's?
5
b's. So, when you cancel all the b's, what will happen? What did I say? The numerator, when all the letters or numbers are canceled out, what is the number represent? Okay, 1, very good. So the numerator is 1, the denominator is also 1. So, when a number or the fraction like what we have on the screen, 1 over 1, we can always say that it is equals to
1.
Can you see it now? That's how any number or letter which is to the power of 0 is always equals to
1.
And a number with a 0 or a letter with a 0 is known as the 0 indices. 80s and receiving students, by now you should know how to apply the quotient rule in solving 1, the negative indices, 2, the 0 indices. With that, I would like you to do these two exercises and apply the steps of the quotient rule. Now you can find the answer for the two exercises which are on the screen now, using the quotient rule and the expansion method. Who would like to give us the first answer? A. Raise your hands if you have finished exercise A. Good. Okay, 87 students. Let's look at the answer for the first one. Who would like to give us the answer for exercise A? Rachel. Sorry, Diana. What do you think the answer for A is? Exercise A? Class, let's listen to what she's saying.
8 to the power of -1, but when there is a power by 1, you can also write the base by itself, A.
Okay, very good. So the answer for A is 8 to the power of -1, or you can have the numerator 1 and the base only letter A, like on the board. It's equals to 8 to the power of -1, and also it is equals to 1 over A, okay? Because A, any number which is always over 1 is equals to 1, so 1 over A, okay? Class, exercise B. What is the answer for exercise B? 4 to the power of? Huh? Sorry. Exercise B. 4 to the power of 5 over 4 to the power of 5 is equals to 4. 5 minus 5 is equals to 4 to the power of 0, which is equals to 1. Okay, the first one, we said A times A times A times A times A over 6A, sir. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. When we cancel, how many A's on the denominator? Okay, 1. So our answer is 1 over A. For B, 4 to the power of 5. 4 times 4. Okay, how many 4s in the denominator? 5 again. And then when we cancel out, how many numbers left in the numerator? None. So all becomes 1, and the denominator also, so which is equals to 1. 87 students, how to calculate the negative indices and the zero indices by applying the quotient rule. With that, class, our key phrase for today's lesson is negative indices and zero indices. In our next lesson, we are going to look at more on how to apply the quotient rule and the product rule. Thank you very much, 87 students, for your participation.